Welcome to Windows 10, Customizing the Desktop, presented by the Buffalo and Erie County Public Library. Now let's go over some of the customizations you can make to your Windows 10 desktop. One thing we can do is click on a file or shortcut and then drag it to the recycle bin. Clicking in this instance means hovering your pointer over the file you wish to move, pressing down on the primary button, then dragging the file where you wish to release it, and then letting go of the primary button. By default, on your Windows computer, the primary button will be the button on the left side of the mouse, which you would click with your index finger if you are using your right hand. If you delete something by accident and you wish to restore it, you can simply double-click on the recycle bin icon, select the file or files you wish to restore, and then select the appropriate option from Manage. When you restore the file, it will return to the same folder on your computer that you deleted it from, but it might not appear in the same place in the file list. The primary button is used to select, drag, and open things. However, there is also a secondary button, which is used to open menus. This secondary button will, by default, be on the right-hand side of your device. Using the secondary button, also commonly known as a right click, will open a different menu depending on what you're hovering over when you use it. In this case, I'll use it to rename a file. I can also open a menu on the blank area of the desktop itself, which provides us with some useful personalization functions. Display settings is an excellent area to start with because we can change the size of icons and text. Notice you may have to restart the computer for these changes to take effect on some apps. If an app does not change, there may be settings within that app itself to improve readability. Since the display settings opens up the actual computer settings, we have the option of using the search bar in the upper left-hand corner to search for other functions we may find important. For example, if we type in mouse here, we see numerous options for mouse settings. To change a mouse from a right-handed mouse to a left-handed mouse, we can select the setting mouse and touchpad once we've typed in the word mouse. If we type in ease of access, we can then uncover the accessibility features in Windows 10. Under mouse settings, we could change the visibility of the pointer. Narrator allows us to turn on on-screen narration. Magnifier gives us another option for those hard-to-read icons and texts. Notice there's a few different ways of using the magnifier. High contrast allows us to change the entire theme of Windows to make reading easier. And there are many other functions to look for. Now that I've turned some of these functions on and off, my desktop has gotten a little rearranged. I can either move everything back in place by hand, or I can use the sort feature by right-clicking on the desktop to automatically sort my icons. A popular feature in Windows is the ability to change your desktop wallpaper, and Windows 10 offers other customization options as well. You can use them by right-clicking on the desktop and selecting Personalize. In the background, you can use your own picture or pictures that Microsoft provides for you. You can change the color of your taskbar, start menu, and tiles. Changing the lock screen will change the picture you see before you sign into your computer. You can also adjust some of the behavior of the start menu and taskbar here. Be sure to check out our other Windows 10 videos for more in-depth information about some of these options. Thank you for watching this tutorial video provided by the Buffalo and Erie County Public Library.